solids, in particle lead and flows, are characterized by different geometrical and physical properties, which are worthy of a statistical analysis. The particle dimensions, for instance, can be characterized by the particle size distribution, which can be easily determined by a sieve analysis. This is obtained by stacking sieves with varying dimensions of mesh, releasing a granular sample consisting of NP particles from the top, and counting the number of particles retained by each sieve, that is NP1, NP2, NP3. Of course, NP1 plus NP2 plus NP3 is equal to NP. From these results, it is possible to build a discrete number frequency distribution, a histogram indicating the relative number of particles in each size interval j, which here is called f tilde nj, and it is defined as the ratio between the number of particles in the interval, npj, and the total number of particles in the sample, np. Each sieve is associated a characteristic size range with midpoint dpj and width delta dpj. Therefore, the discrete number frequency distribution is usually expressed with the particle size on the horizontal axis. Going to the limit of delta dpj to zero, the continuous number frequency distribution can be obtained. The relative number of particles, f tilde nj, tends to fn, so that fn times ddp is the probability that an individual particle has a size between dp minus ddp divided by 2 and dp plus ddp divided by 2. Two important statistical parameters can be obtained from the fn distribution: the mean particle diameter, called mu dp, which is the integral of dp ranging from 0 to infinity of the product dp times fn dp times ddp; the standard deviation of particle diameters, called sigma dp, which is the square root of the integral of dp ranging from 0 to infinity of dp minus mu dp to the square times fn dp times ddp. The cumulative number distribution function, capital Fn dp, is the integral from 0 to dp of the continuous number frequency distribution, and it represents the probability that an individual particle has a size lower than or equal to dp. From the cumulative distribution, which is monotonically increasing from 0 to 1, the median number diameter dp capital M can be obtained. This is the value of dp for which the cumulative distribution is 0.5. Similarly, one can define as dpq the particle diameter corresponding to a cumulative distribution equal to q%. The Lock-Nockmeyer distribution is usually employed for analytically describing the size of solid particles. This curve is derived from the Gaussian distribution, and it expresses fn as a function of dp and two parameters, namely the mean particle diameter mu dp and the standard deviation of particle diameters, sigma dp. When deciding which model is the best to simulate a given particle laden flow, it is of fundamental importance to assess whether, at least in a first approximation, the particles can be treated as monodisperse, that is, all identical to each other. The feasibility of this assumption can be verified from the shape of the number frequency distribution. A rough criterion is that a mixture of particles can be modeled as monodisperse if the ratio between the standard deviation and the mean particle diameter is lower than 0.1. For instance, glass beads with a very narrow particle size distribution might be treated as monodisperse. However, the assumption might be no longer acceptable for broadly graded natural materials. Another important feature of the dispersed phase, which strongly affects its fluid dynamic behavior, is the shape of the particles. The shape of the particles is very difficult to characterize, primarily because it is difficult to quantify by a number, and additionally because it is virtually different for all particles. Several indexes have been proposed to provide a rough indication of the particle shape. One of the most widely used is the particle spherical coefficient, called phi, that is, the ratio between the surface area of a sphere having the same volume of the considered particle and the actual surface area of the particle. The particle spherical coefficient of a spherical particle is equal to 1, a value which might not be unreasonable, for instance, for artificial glass beads. In the case of natural materials, typical recommendations are 0.86, 0.76 and 0.66 for fully rounded, nearly rounded and sharp grains, respectively. The last characteristics of the dispersed phase that will be discussed in this lesson is the maximum packing volume fraction, called alpha PM, which refers to the limiting condition of complete compaction of particles. Alpha PM depends on the particle size distribution and the particle shape, and estimates can be obtained for regular geometries. For instance, for packed cubes, alpha PM is equal to 1, whereas for spheres in close packing, it is 0.74. However, if the spheres are randomly packed, then alpha PM reaches only about 0.63.